Home after an historic day in the nation's capital. They joined tens of thousands to observe the 50th anniversary of the historic March on Washington. They relived a turning point in the fight for civil rights. The 1963 march and speech by Dr. Martin Luther King sparked the passage of the Civil Rights Act and the Voting Rights Act 1 year later. WESH 2's Talitha Vickers is live at the NAACP headquarters here in Orlando, where, Talitha, you've been hearing what it was like to be in D.C. yesterday.
Amanda, many say that this commemorative march really played a major role, was so impactful, even 50 years later. Many just returned here to the NAACP office for a regularly scheduled meeting. I caught up with them as they debriefed about the events that unfolded in Washington, and they say pretty much overall they were really impressed by the youth turnout taking a stand for equality for all people.
It was such a moving experience. It's really hard to totally explain it to you.
Reginald McGill was among the tens of thousands gathered to mark the 50th anniversary of the March on Washington. He says the turnout at the National Mall 50 years later speaks volumes about where we have come as a nation and where we need to be.
Though there appears to be some similarities, there are still challenges. By that way, there are still unemployment and underemployment. And that was the case then, that's the case now. Then the labor unions were much stronger. Now the labor unions, unfortunately, are not as strong as they have been in the past. There are still discrimination, but then when we see that we've elected a president who happens to be African American, we've come a long way.
An appearance by Trayvon Martin's mother, Sabrina Fulton, resonated with many of the youth in attendance.
Trayvon Martin was my son. But he's not just my son. He's all of our son, and we have to fight for our children.
Free at last! Free at last!
Melinda Poole also attended and says Dr. Martin Luther King's I Have a Dream speech in 1963 that led to the Civil Rights Act and the Voting Rights Act continues to be a work in progress.
The march was very instrumental in reminding us of the issues that affected us 50 years ago and those issues that currently affect us now.
Now, the student group, the Dream Defenders, which stays a protest at the governor's office protesting Stand Your Ground law, rather, with a 31-day protest at the governor's office. Well, they were also in attendance. Many say their efforts were a step in the right direction. Meantime, others say that they are focused on the march, which symbolizes the civil rights of all people. Reporting live from Orange County, Talitha Vickers, WESH 2 News.